everyone, it's Carrie with Viewership, and today we are talking end cards. So today I wanted to walk you through just sort of the idea behind end cards, how to use templates, how to import from video, and what your options are, what these elements are, and what they mean for your channel. So I'm going to go ahead and this is a video I created for how to make thumbnails. I'm going to get rid of these end cards so we can start from scratch. So I'm going to edit element and delete, and you can do this as well. That's how you edit end cards. Okay, so the idea behind end cards is they are interactive clickable cards that show up during the last 20 seconds of your video, and they're a way to help your viewers either see more of your content through a video or a playlist, subscribe to your channel through a clickable icon, and you can also promote other channels if you'd like, or you can link out to an approved website. So the options you have are to add these elements manually every time you create a video. So you can just click here and say, let's see, I'm talking about thumbnails in this video. So people may also be interested in upload a video of mine about editing videos. So we can go ahead and select this video if we want to make it a card, and you click create element, and you're going to see it pop up right here. Now the cool thing about this as well is you can click on your card, your end card, and drag it, click on this element, drag it, so you could have it covering up your video. If you were in the video and let's say it popped up over your face, you definitely want to move the card so it's not over your face, but you can play with these and you can get super creative. Let's see if we add another element, a subscribe button. We'll click create. Okay, and that's, see, now these are overlapping, so I want to take this element, the subscribe element, move it over here. I can move it up to the top right, down to the bottom right. I'm just gonna juggle these. And you can play with them until you get a look and feel that you like. This element you could create, or I'm sorry, you can promote another channel. We're not gonna do that right now. We don't have another channel that we want to promote. Or you can link to an approved website. We could link to viewership.com. And in order to do that, you would need to upload a custom image. Let's see. Oh, 6 characters over limit. Okay, so you've got your title for your element, link to your website, call to action. This is just going to show up. I'll show you in a second. Let's say sign up. We've got an image that we like. I'm not going to use this permanently. I just want to show you how this works. But again, there you go. That's linking out to a website. So if we move that here, we've got our elements. Okay, so we've got a subscribe button. We're linking out to our website, and we have a video. So up here, you'll see a little preview slider. If you click on this, it's going to show you how this will look to your viewers during the last 20 seconds. So click play. I'm going to mute myself. Okay. And then if you hover over your elements, this is what shows up for your viewers. So that's where that call to action came in. You got to pick your call to action, sign up. And that's your title, Viewership Marketing Agency. So you can have that say anything, like learn how to optimize your videos. You can have it say whatever you want. So that's really cool. I'm going to go ahead and delete all of these, and I'm going to show you how to pull in end cards from a previous video. So if you want to keep your end cards looking consistent and similar in every single video. You can absolutely do that. You click on import from video, and you can just choose if you're doing the same end card template for every single video, everything looks exactly the same. Click on import, and it's going to import exactly what you had in your last video. Same positioning, everything. So that's a really easy option you have here. Let's go ahead and delete these as well. Let's say you're brand new to YouTube. You've never used end cards. You don't feel like designing anything. You can use one of YouTube's templates. So if you click on use template, they'll show you a bunch of different options. And you can, I mean, the sky's the limit. You could make all four of your elements videos or playlists. And if you just, let's click on this, select, and then you need to go in and choose a video or playlist. Click on edit. Do that playlist. And then you just go through and you populate each one of these elements. You're only allowed to have four elements, so you can't add like 20 in here and crowd up your screen. Move these around a little bit if you want. Oops. Add a video. And another video. Okay, and we'll preview this. All right, see, I moved this. I don't like how this looks. So I'm just going to pause and drag this back. And let's preview it again. You'll see they fade on. It's really nice, and your viewers are able to click and watch more of your content. And that is how you add end cards. So if you guys have any questions about end cards, let me know. And if there are any step-by-step tutorials or questions you have about how to optimize your videos on YouTube, how to edit, please leave comments down below. And also head on over to viewership. We are launching a beta program here soon, and it's going to help YouTube content creators edit and optimize their videos. So make sure you get on our wait list, and I will see you in the next video.